We'll revise today the complex numbers. Okay. So complex numbers. Now, anyone, what are real numbers? What are real numbers? Anyone?
Sir, all the rational as well as irrational numbers are called real numbers.
Collection of real number, collection of rational numbers
and irrational
numbers. And irrational numbers is known as real numbers. Okay. Now, anyone, what is the solution of this equation? You know how to solve this equation? What is solution of this equation?
Plus minus 1.
If you solve it, you will get two solutions of this quadratic equation, which is minus 1 and 1, and both of them belongs to real numbers, because x and minus 1 both are real numbers. Minus 1 and 1 are both real numbers. Okay. Now, if I say solve this equation, anyone, how can you solve this equation? Now, what's the solution of this equation? Anyone? Yes, beta, speak loudly.
Sir, under root minus 1.
Under root, you are saying that
x is equal to under root minus 1.
X is equal to under root
minus 1.
Now, can you solve this under root minus 1?
No, sir.
Now, this is not a real number. It not belongs to real number. Okay? It is not belongs to real number. So, we now come to another term or a number which is not a real number, which is known as
imaginary number.
It is known as imaginary number. Okay. Now, what are imaginary number? Can anyone now define it? What is this imaginary number?
The number which are not real is known as imaginary number.
Saying just the reverse of it.
Which is always smaller than zero.
Smaller than zero? No. Not. Wo to smaller than zero to integers ho jayenge, negative integers.
Sorry. Whose squares are not in positive terms?
Only can say the numbers whose square is negative, or the square root of negative numbers. The square root of negative numbers is known as imaginary number. The square root of negative number is known as imaginary numbers. Okay. Now, we denote this square root of a negative number as by a sign, this iota we call it. Okay. It is known as the imaginary number. And if we squaring both the sides, I am getting this. So the square of any number which is negative is known as an imaginary number, and we have denoted it by I. So whenever you are solving equation and you are getting a square root of negative number, then it will be a imaginary number. So we denote it by this sign I or iota, and therefore squaring both the sides, we are getting as I square is equal to minus 1. So, This is the formula you have to learn, that I square is equal to minus 1. Now, what is the value of I cube? Yes, beta, Sneha, Sneha, Kavya, you tell.
Sir, I cube minus I.
Minus I.
That is I square into I. It is equal to minus 1 into I. That is equal to. So the value of this I cube is equal to minus I. Okay? Now, I key power 4.
1.
1.
How it is 1? For I key power 4, you can write
this. I square into I square.
Good. It is equal to how much? It is equal to 1. So the value of I key power 4 is equal to 1. So we say that any power of I, which is the multiple of 4, its value will be equal to 1. Its value will be equal to 1. Okay? That is, if it is I key power, let us say 8, it is a multiple of 4. So its value also equal to 1. So any power of I, which is a multiple of 4, its value is equal to 1. Okay. So now let us take some higher powers of these I. I'm taking it as, suppose I raised to power 37. Yes, how can we solve it? Any higher power?
I to the power 4 into 9 plus 1.
Means convert into multiple of 4. Convert I key power 37 to the power of I as a multiple of 4, or you always write in the form I raised to power 4 into quotient into I key power remainder. You always write in this form when we have the higher power of. So you write like this: 4 9s are 36, it is a quotient, and I raised to power 1, which is remainder. You divide 37 by 4. Okay. So this is the remainder. This is the quotient. And you always write in this form. You always write in this form. Okay. So this is 1 into I key power 1 is I. So it is equal to I. So I raised to power 37 is equal to how much? I raised to power. It is only equal to I. Clear? Yes. Anyone? What is the value of this? I raised to power 4 and plus 3. Or I write like this. Agar aapko confusion hai thoda sa. I raised to power 4 and plus 3. What is the value of this?
Sir, minus I.
Yes, minus I, yes. How can you say that it is minus I?
Sir, I raised to power 4 and into I raised to the power 3.
You are saying like this, na?
Yes, sir.
Why? I raised to power 4 into power n, I key power 3.
1.
And this I key power 4 is equal to 1?
Yes, sir.
The power n, and I cube is minus I.
Minus I.
So I power n is 1. 1 raised to power n is equal to 1. Minus I. So it is equal to
minus I.
So this is the value, minus I. This is the value of this. I raised to power 4 n plus 3. Okay? Yeah, okay. I raised to power any power of I raised to power. Now, if you have any imaginary number in the denominator like this, how you have to solve it?
Rationalize.
If you rationalize it, that is, you can multiply numerator and denominator by I. You have to always write the imaginary number in the numerator. Okay? You have to always write in the numerator. So I upon minus 1, that is
minus I.
Minus. You have to always write in the imaginary, as you write the irrational number in the numerator, you have to always rationalize the denominator when we have the irrational number like this. Okay? So after irrational number in the denominator, you always rationalize like this. You don't leave it the answer in the form of irrational number in the denominator. Similarly, whenever you have the imaginary number in the denominator, you have to rationalize it. That is, we have to bring it to the numerator. Clear, okay, beta? Now, after that, now you know the imaginary number. Now, anyone, what is a complex number?
A number which contains one real number and one imaginary number.
Not both. It's not necessary that it contain both. Any expression of the form x plus iy is another complex number where x and y both are the real numbers. These two numbers are real numbers. This I denotes that it is the imaginary part of this complex number, and it is generally denoted by z. That equally, we a plus ib. A plus ib is a complex number where a and b both belongs to real number. Now, this complex number contains two parts, the imaginary part and the real part. Now, real part of this complex number is denoted by this REZ is equal to A. The real part hai, hai na? And imaginary part of this complex number?
B.
It is B, not IB. I only denotes that it is the imaginary part of this complex number. It is the imaginary part. So, what is the imaginary part of this complex number? It is B. So, let us take any complex number Z1 minus 3 minus 2i. So, its real part is
minus 3.
Its imaginary part is
Minus 2.
This is a complex number. Now, as we denote the complex number in a Argand plane means, as we have a rectangular coordinate system, so similarly for the complex numbers, we have the rectangular coordinate system, which we call it a Argand plane. Let us take this rectangular coordinate system. This is the x-axis and y-axis, but in Argand plane, this is known as the real axis, and this is known as the imaginary axis. So, if we have any complex number, suppose z, 2, 3, so it denotes that it is a complex number as 2 plus 3i. If we denote that there is a complex number of z in the Argand plane 2, 3, it means that is a complex number whose imaginary real part is 2 and imaginary part is 3. And if we represent this on Argand plane, it will be this. This is 2, 3, a complex number 2, 3. Clear? So, this is the representation of any complex number in the Argand plane. Clear, beta? You are not replying. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Real number.
Okay. Now, if I join this with the origin, this point with the origin, and draw perpendicular on the x-axis. Now, what this distance denotes? The distance kitna hoga?
Yes, sir. 3.
It is distance from the x-axis. 3 hoga? And what is this distance?
2.
Yes, sir.
It's 2. And let us say this angle is the angle made by this line segment joining the complex number with the origin. Now, this OZ is called the amplitude, is known as the modulus of the complex number. And it is denoted by this modulus sign, and it is equal to under root Pythagoras. You can use the Pythagoras, na? 9 plus 4, 13. This is known as the modulus of the complex number. And suppose in place of 2, 3, we have a complex number x plus iy. So its modulus will be, we'll tell?
Under root x square plus y square.
Very good. Under root x square plus y square. So this is the formula to find the modulus of the complex number. This is a formula to find the modulus of the complex number. Again. So now you know the complex number, what is a complex number, what is the modulus of the complex numbers, and after that we have the conjugate of the complex numbers. Conjugate of complex number. Conjugate of the complex number. Yes, anyone who can define? Suppose this is the complex number. So what is the conjugate of the complex number? Yes, Vida, anyone of you? You have done it. Yes, anyone?
X minus
I. The z dash is equal to x minus I.
Means you have to change the sign of the imaginary part. You have to change the sign of the imaginary part. This is the meaning of
conjugate
of the complex number. Okay? This is the meaning of conjugate of the complex numbers. Clear? Now after that, suppose minus 2 minus 3i, its value is
minus 2 plus 3i.
You have to change the sign of the imaginary part. Minus 2 plus 3i. Okay? Like this. So this is the conjugate, this is the modulus of the complex numbers. After that, we have addition, subtraction, multiplication, divisions of the complex number. And the complex number you have to write always in the standard form. What is the standard form of the complex number? Anyone?
A plus IB.
You have to write always any answer in the form A plus IB. This is the standard form of the complex number. Suppose you have to add or subtract these two complex numbers. You have to subtract these two complex numbers. So you have to always write this in the form A plus IB. So it is 2 minus 3. It is minus 1.
Minus 1 plus 4i.
E plus this, it is 4i. And this is the standard form of the complex number. So the standard form. Ye form hai aapki. The standard form of this complex number. Clear? So you can say like this. How can you find the value of this? how can you find it? Or how can you simplify? Four? How it is four?
Four को sir two into two कर देंगे.
You solve like this. You find the square of this a square plus b square minus 2ab. Find first of all the square. I square is minus 1. I square is minus 1, so it is equal to minus 2i ka square. That is 4i square. And I square is minus 1.
Minus
4.
So it is minus 4. And you have to write in the standard form. So you write like this. Minus 4 plus 0i. Minus 4 plus 0i. Clear? Yes.
Yes, sir.
After that, we have a multiplicative inverse. Now, what is the meaning of multiplicative inverse? What is the meaning of multiplicative inverse?
Sir, reciprocal.
Multiplicative inverse of, if I say, I. What is the meaning of multiplicative inverse of I?
1 upon i.
Matlab 1 upon i. Reciprocal. And you don't have to leave this in this form. 1 upon i.
Rationalize.
We have to write in the standard form. That means you have to rationalize it. That is minus i, 0 minus i.
Yes.
Standard form.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the multiplicative inverse of 2 minus i?
1 upon
2
minus i.
1 upon 2 minus i. Now, can you leave this as the answer?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Why?
To rationalize.
Why? Why we cannot leave it?
So because this is not in standard form.
This is not in the standard form. So it means you have to rationalize it. So how you have to rationalize it? कैसे करते हैं इसका
रेशलाइज़? 2 plus i
upon 2 plus i. Multiply numerator and denominator by its conjugate. You have to always rationalize it by multiplying and dividing by its conjugate. You know the conjugate of this? 2 minus i का conjugate 2 plus i. So whenever you have to write rationalize the complex number in the denominator, you have to write the answer in the form. You have to multiply and divide by its conjugate. So, multiply. So, a square, we always get the a square minus b square in the denominator. Okay. So, 4 i square is minus 1. Plus 1 clear as of course. Plus 1 is
equal to 1. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
2 plus i, it is upon 5.
5.
2 upon standard formula, right? Like this. Yes, any short then I have to. You have to write like this. Standard form. A plus IB. Now, what is the real part of this complex number?
2 upon 5.
Imaginary part of this complex number?
1 upon 5.
Okay. Here are some basics for this complex number. To represent a complex number in the polar form is not in your syllabus. It has been deleted. Okay. Now, I'm now taking the problem of yours exercise wise. Okay. Now, any problem in the exercise first to anyone? Exercise 5.1. Yes, anyone? Any part? Exercise 5.1 to anyone? Bolo beta.
No, sir.
Itlo, anyone? Or koi? Can you do this? Question number this 14.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes, sir.
P plus. It is 3 plus. 3 plus root 5 i multiply by 3 minus root 5 I upon, we have root 3 plus root 2 I minus root 3 minus root 2 I. Yes, anyone, how can we solve it?
Sir, you have to write
In the numerator, you have to multiply it.
Yes, sir.
In the denominator, you have to subtract these two complex numbers. Is the difference? Yes, and in the numerator, we are getting a identity of a square minus b square. In the numerator, we are getting the identity of a square minus b square. In the denominator, this is cancel ho gaya aapka. And you are getting 2 root 2i. Root 2i plus root 2i minus minus plus. Minus minus plus. So what you are getting now? We are getting this as
9 plus 5i
square upon 2 root 2.
2 under root 2i.
I square is minus 1. We are getting 9 plus 5.
Plus 5 upon 2 under root 2i.
Equal to 14 upon 14. Root 2i.
2 under root 2i.
7 upon root 2i. Can I write yes. Answer? Can I leave this as an answer?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
We have to rationalize it because we have the irrational number as well as the imaginary number in the denominator. So it means we have to rationalize it by multiplying and dividing by root 2i. Because this is not in the standard form. So it is 2i square. 2i square is 7 root
minus 2.
I square is how much? Minus 1.
Minus 1.
It is the 0 minus 7 upon 2 root 2i. This is the standard form. This is the standard form.
Yes.
Again, I have taken this and question number 8 I have already explained to you. Yes, any other problem in this exercise to anyone?
No, sir.
Anyone?
No, sir.
One. Okay. No, exercise 5.2 is not there in your syllabus this year. Yes, any problem in your exercise 5.3? You have to solve these quadratic equations, and all these quadratic equations have imaginary roots. Yes, anyone? Any problem in this?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Any other? Anyone?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
The quadratic is solved. And in these quadratic equation, you are getting the discriminant as negative. In all these questions, you will get the imaginary roots. In class 10, when you are solving the quadratic equations, you are getting the real roots. Means, how can I say that this quadrication have real roots? How can you tell? Yes, anyone?
And if the discriminant is greater than 0, then then it has real roots.
Because in this, the discriminant, which is b square minus 4ac, they are getting this as, you are getting as minus 7. And now, because b is less than 0, so it will have imaginary roots. In class 10th, you are getting the discriminant as greater or equal to 0. Class 10th mein aap greater or equal to 0 aa raha tha aapka. Okay? So, usme real roots the. Yahan par aapke, you will get the imaginary roots. So, what is the formula? Minus b plus minus root d upon 2a. So, what is b? B is 1. What is d? Minus 7 upon 2 into a. So, minus 1. Now, how can you write this root minus 7? 7.
7.
7i.
Root 7i. Good. Upon 7. 2. Upon 4.
4.
Can I leave the answer as it is? Can I leave the answer as it is?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No.
Why?
it is not in the standard form.
This is not in the standard form. So I will break it into real part and imaginary part. Like this. Plus minus root 7 upon 4 I. These are the roots of this quadratic equation, which are imaginary. In all the questions of this exercise 5.3, where you have to solve the quadratic equation, you will get the imaginary roots. Now, any problem in this exercise, miscellaneous exercise of your NCERT book? Any problem in the NCERT book and miscellaneous exercise to anyone? बेटा इसमें तो आनी चाहिए प्रॉब्लम अरे नहीं ऐसा नहीं हो सकता इसमें तो है ठीक ठाक क्वेश्चन है हाँ बोलो बेटा स्पीक लाउडली क्वेश्चन नंबर आई एम नॉट गेटिंग यू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू ओके मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज Question number 2. Now what is being asked in question number 2? Rather you have to prove that there are two complex numbers Z1 and Z2. You have to prove that real part of Z1 into Z2 is equal to real part of Z1 into real part of Z2 minus imaginary part of Z1 into imaginary part of Z2. It is looking like that it is a very difficult question or theoretical question, but it is very, very easy. Now let the two complex numbers Z1 as A plus IB and the second complex number Z2 B C plus ID. Now what you have to find? Real part of Z1 into Z2. So means you have to multiply these two complex numbers. And write in the standard form. You'll get this is C plus C plus ID. This is C plus ID. Now multiply it A into C, A into D I, B into C I, and B into D I square. Are you getting it?
Yes.
Collect the like terms means write in the standard form. ये minus one minus bd clear है?
Yes sir.
I square is minus one. Now write in the standard form. This is the standard form. Now what you have to find? You have to find the real part of this Z1 into Z2. Now, what is the real part of Z1 into Z2?
AC minus BD
is the real part of this Z1 into Z2. This is the real part of Z1 into Z2. Now, what is A? A kya hai yahan par? What is A? A is the real part of Z1. Real part of Z1. Now, what is this C? C is the real part of Z2 minus what is B? B is the
imaginary part of Z1
and what is D? It is
imaginary part of Z2.
So this is the true. Again, thoda difficult tha, one part I'm adding it now. If I ask what will be the imaginary part of Z1 into Z2, you can add in your NCERT book. Z1 into Z2, it will be, what is the imaginary part?
AD plus BC.
AD plus BC. And what is A? A is real part of Z1. What is B? It is imaginary part of Z2. What is B? B kidhar hai here? This is imaginary part of Z1. And what is C? C is the real part of it. This is, you can add in your NCERT book. Okay, this is the second part. This is the second part. Okay, you can add this in your book. This is not given in your NCERT book. Clear? Okay. So if you have any problem, we can take some time in the next lecture. Otherwise, we'll revise the trigonometry in the next lecture. Okay. Wait for a minute. I am taking your attendance.